Our guest tonight is not only our greatest living explorer, but he's been an inspiration to countless Americans. Is there any unexplored land left on this earth?
Yes, there is. An area as big as the United States that's never been seen by a human being.
Admiral, an expedition to which I believe you're the advisor is now en route. What is that expedition doing?
And it's a reconnaissance expedition to make certain observations and to look for some bases, because the government has really become interested. I tell you one reason they're interested. It's by far the most valuable, important place left in the world. It has to do with the future of the nation, because we've found enough coal up to supply the whole world for quite a while.
Admiral, is there a competition among other nations to try to get information about Antarctica and possibly to secure some of these resources?
There are now seven nations very much interested.
I was going to ask you, does it have military importance?
It has some.
But Admiral Byrd, are private expeditions a thing of the past?
I think down south, it may be more or less a thing of the past.
This latest expedition now on the way is a government expedition, I take it.
Yes, that's the government.
Okay, well, thank you very much, Admiral Byrd.
Ollie, come over here and hold down the vice pedal so I can get the metal from the other side.
Later, I'm busy.
Doing what?
Trying to locate Dad on the pendant. Later, I'm busy. Later, I'm busy. Later, I'm busy. Later, I'm busy. Later, I'm busy.
I think it's hail. We made something happen, something to do with the weather.
The pylon has something to do with the weather.
The
pylons control the weather, control the weather, control the weather, control the weather.
It's dead. The crystals have been removed from the matrix. And the pylons control the weather. And without their crystals, the pylons can't work, which might explain why we're having this drought. Looks like one of the crystals is missing.
Well, I think it must have happened when we went over the waterfall. Like it seemed to fall through a hole in space.
You have fallen through a dimensional doorway.
Where'd you come from?
From the doorway. From the doorway. From the doorway. From the doorway.
The pylons have something to do with the time doorway.
The mist of the time doorway did not draw you into the vortex.
A huge hole in space. Will your doorway work all right now?
Yes. Yes, it works.
Look, it's home!
At the spiriting out of the two spacecraft out of Berlin Point, they were taken into Antarctica, and there they disappeared, and they were not heard of for some time. Reports indicated, and they were operative once again. Now, there was a major concern by world powers to go in and capture the technology and the two spacecraft which they knew were in Antarctica. Did that one known as Admiral Byrd was to be recommissioned, and he was to be sent in there to retrieve the two saucers. Admiral Byrd was given an unlimited funding to go in and pull this thing successfully off. That within 8 weeks, he was totally defeated. That there was an advanced civilization and technology, most probably alien. There were with the Third Reich and the SS who was in Antarctica, and that those great and developed technologies were used to defeat Admiral Byrd. And of course, as it turns out, even to date, they're still there. We never did successfully get them.
At the South Pole, it is clear that under the structures of ice, there was some type of civilization there. The evidences of huge dinosaur intelligence suggest that this was one of the possible places for the Garden of Eden. Extraterrestrial intelligence is also operated out of the area of the South Pole. And in that sense, the South Pole is a connecting point with other civilizations, possible extrasolar gardens of paradise, extrasolar gardens of paradise, extrasolar gardens of paradise.
За 3-9 земель к берегам ледяной Антарктиды скрытно направляются немецкие субмарины, а через некоторое время Дёнец роняет странную фразу: «Мои подводники обнаружили настоящий земной рай».
I have done nothing. Kill my resurgences. Good night, Rick Marshall.
Human beings, it's been 1,000 moons since anything so delighted Malik's eye. Who are you?
Come on, let's go get some carrots. Let's go find a turnip to go with it.